Jesse, thank you so much. Well, I tell you what, joining us this afternoon is Sue Tinsdale. She's here in the community corner today to talk about a very special walk that's coming up. And I tell you one thing. First of all, I want you to tell people why you're involved in this walk, and then we'll get to talking about it a little bit more.
Sure, Simone. So my son struggled with substance abuse disorder for approximately 12 years. Mm-hmm. Started his sophomore year of high school, and he died from an opioid overdose mm-hmm. 2 weeks before his 29th birthday. Mm-hmm. And it was at that time thereafter that my daughter suggested that we start mm-hmm. something locally in Central Illinois to bring awareness and education and prevention and bring this more to the surface to have the discussion.
And this is an overdose awareness walk that you're talking about?
Yes.
Now, when is this happening?
So this year it's a Saturday, August 31st,
okay.
which that is also International Overdose Awareness mm-hmm. Day. And this year we added that this will be not just focused at overdose and remembering those that we've lost, but also invite individuals that are, and their families, that may be struggling with addiction, mm-hmm. substance abuse, and bring some light to the fact that recovery is mm-hmm. possible.
Absolutely. So this is not only a day to remember, but it's an educational opportunity also.
Correct.
Wow. So who's going to be there to offer this advice to people or give them the education they need about overdose?
So we will have a variety of local speakers, people that have real life personal experience with addiction and also recovery, individuals that professionally provide treatment that mm-hmm. can give us a little bit more information and facts about what treatments are available, mm-hmm. what they are, mm-hmm. and what they consist of. And this year we are really pleased to add Hidden in Plain Sight, which is being provided by Hancock County Substance Abuse Coalition. And this is essentially a bedroom mm-hmm. of a young person, per se, that is set up with hidden identifiers, possibly to detect that this individual may be hiding and undisclosing a drug mm-hmm. or alcohol or paraphernalia. Mm-hmm. It's educational, it brings awareness, and I feel it's very beneficial to offer to the community.
Well, you're absolutely right, especially in these days, because this is just becoming a bigger and bigger problem. Before we run out of time, with your loss, and that's a huge loss for you, but has this, being involved with this, has really given you a little bit of, I don't know the word to say, but your son is probably smiling down with you with what you're doing, because you're able to help others. You may not have been able to help him, but you can help others. And how does that make you feel, knowing that you can still maybe help someone else?
It thoroughly breaks my heart that I was not educated and did not understand opioid use disorder when my son was struggling. And I really feel that now being able to help others mm-hmm. better understand this so that they can help and support their family member or loved one at whatever capacity that may be, it's healing mm-hmm. for me. I wish that someone would have done that with me. So we don't want anyone to have to go through what we have experienced.
And you're making sure of that by doing this and being involved. Again, that is on August 31st.
Yes.
Is the cost free to be a part of this walk?
Yes, this is free and mm-hmm. open to the public. Everyone's welcome to attend.
Wallace Park in Canton from 1 to 3 p.m. And donations are appreciated, of course, and T-shirts will be on sale. You know, I tell you, thank you so much for being here. It's always good to see you, you know?
Thank you.
Very uplifting.
Thank you, Simone. I appreciate the opportunity.
All right, and we'll be right back after.